Chicago 250624, provided by Disc Penwing. Penwing. Penguin. Penguin. Lucifer, who is Enki, who is Ea. Lucifer personifies humanitarian goodness and enlightenment. All other characterizations of Lucifer are blasphemous and inaccurate. In the Freudian sense, Lucifer is the self rebelling against the superego, the psychic faculty analogous to the judging and condemning father figure, both internally and externally. For the sake of empowering the ego ideal, Lucifer is the psychic faculty analogous with the rewarding and benevolent mother figure. Put very simply, Lucifer is the self choosing to be ruled by love rather than fear. Therefore, Luciferian consciousness is in league with the feminine right hemisphere of the brain, be it represented by the yin of the yin-yang, the chalice of the chalice blade, or the spirit of Napoleon's spirit sword. There are only two forces in the whole world, the sword and the spirit. In the long run, the sword will always be conquered by the spirit. Napoleon Bonaparte said this. Of course, there are many other representations of these two eternal polarities which exist in all matter. In the Sumerian stories, Lucifer is commensurate with Enki, the creator of humanity. While facing much opposition from his malevolent brother Enlil, who is representative of left-brain patriarchal consciousness, Enki saves, enlightens humankind in the garden, clothes them after Enlil drives them out, and saves humanity from the deluge with which Enlil attempted to destroy humanity. The God of the Old Testament is a composite character formed by combining these two forces. Good and evil must exist in an interlocked package. One is defined by the existence of the other. Light and darkness, life and death, right and left, are brothers of one another. They are inseparable. Because of this, neither are the good good, nor evil evil, nor is it life life, nor death death. For this reason, each one will dissolve into its original nature. But those who are exalted above the world are indissoluble, eternal, the gospel of Philip. As Albert Pike points out, yes, Lucifer is God, and unfortunately, Adonai is also God. For the eternal law is that there is no light without shade, no beauty without ugliness, no white without black. For the absolute can only exist as two gods, darkness being necessary to light, to serve as its foil, as the pedestal is necessary to the statue, and the brake to the locomotive. The doctrine of Satanism is a heresy, I say, and the true and pure philosophic religion is the belief in Lucifer, the equal of Adonai. But Lucifer, God of light and God of good, is struggling for humanity against Adonai, the God of darkness and evil. Therefore, an age of Lucifer will be an age of enlightenment, Enki, and therefore Lucifer is set to regain his rightful prominence in the Aquarian age, which is now dawning. In the new Aeon of Horus, the crowned and conquering child, tyranny will be replaced by humanitarian concern, and left-brain concerns such as finance will be subservient to human needs. The Enlilite forces which have ruled for so long will be opposed to these ends, but they are no match for the gravity of destiny. The new serpent of creative consciousness will not fit in the old skin of existing institutions. Let us invoke Enki, who is Ea, who is Lucifer, who is Horus, who is Krishna, who is Kalki. Lord, who has made the seed of mankind come forth, who creates good destiny for them, who teaches them the proper practices. He makes august and dignified rites proliferate truly like grass. He assigns the scepters. He distributes the loyal crowns and announces their exalted names. Hail, O Son of the Dawn!
Okay. Let's see how many minutes I have left there. Well, I have 6. So let me see if there's a little song I could add possibly to it. Let me see. Well, I can't find any little song here. I'm going to try. Okay, the video's over. Thank you. Thank you so much for, you know, taking the time to listen. And, you know. All right. So long.